Hi guys, it's Razor Eye, and this is now a tutorial for you to get a four job within 1 hour. Stay tuned and watch the video for more tips. Just a reminder, this will only work for one character per account. To start our tutorial, you need to go back to Prontera. And this is the easy way to level up to the forger job. So first thing that we need to do, shout out to Cam Kyle Linatok for liking this stream. First thing that you need to do is look for this NPC. He will be your guide for the Cryptura Academy. So you need to look for Hammer. Talk to Hammer. Okay, next, you would need to ride a carriage to the Cryptura Academy. So go ahead and look for the NPC. So you would need to talk to Rory, and we'll guide you to the Cryptura Academy. So to those who are new to the game or just going back to the game, you will notice that Cryptura Academy is a new map that was added up, and basically this is where the novice classes will spawn to instead of Prontera. They would go to this Cryptura Academy. Whoa, so have you seen that whale? So big. So next up, we would need to talk to Higer Leafa. Click on away. So here you can choose any job class that you want. You can choose Rune Knight, Warlock, Guillotine Cross, Ranger, Archbishop, Mechanic, Super Novice, Hazy, and we're back to Rune Knight. Choose whichever class that you would want. So my initial class is Ranger, so I would choose Ranger. So once you have selected a job, you will automatically proceed with the NPC that will help you change your job. So for the Ranger class, you will need to talk to Kansky. So it might be a different NPC depending on your job. So does this look familiar? It's the same process as changing jobs. So just click on the proceed button away. Click on it. Click it, click. Hey, so look at my character. She's so happy, she's dancing. And nothing beats free items. Look at her, she can start dancing. At this point, the NPC would ask you which school would you prefer to join, so choose wisely. This is where your skill will depend on. More free items, yay! But wait, there's more! Before you go, make sure that you click on the NPC to trigger the next quest. So make sure you follow this quest to get to the fourth job. So first quest is to check on Heger Leva. We will need to complete this quest to go to the next job, which is Stellar Hunter. Next is we need to wipe out the dense forest squirrel. We also need to wipe out the dense forest parasites. And again, the next important mission is to chat with Heger Leva. So next you get an invitation from Heger for a party. It might be her birthday, so let's join up. So you need to brush up on your secret agent skills because we're going to go deep into the secret realm. So you need to follow Heger Leva's footsteps. Very important. Thank you. Next, we will need to use a lightning arrow to uncover and destroy the country. Because you know, lightning makes invisible things visible. Science. Next, we will have a dance showdown with Cthulhu. What? It's not a dance showdown? So we'll just kill him then. So here's Cthulhu, half hedgehog, half snake, half reindeer, half leaf. So go ahead and defeat Cthulhu. And while you're at it, make sure to avoid the cross attack pattern, because it will cause damage. The backup has arrived. You must need to defeat the dense forest parasite and then Cthulhu. Avoid the cross pattern again. Make sure that you hit him with the money shot. Here we go. Victory! Then you get the shiny thing. But the quest is not over yet. So while we're here, get your handbook from Carrion, the graduation instructor. Talk to your friend again, Eager Leafa. So before we leave this, let's do an obligatory selfie. Say, Cellar Hunter! Next, we need to look for Mathai Sieve in Frontera. Once you talk to him, you will be instantly teleported to Yudo. That saves you money and a ride. Good fellow. Next, you would need to enter the unlimited library. This library is so unlimited. So unlimited. So limited. You need to go ahead following the light. But relax, you're not dead yet. At this point, you can read or view the Book of Ymir, which is not really related to the Ymir of Attack on Titan. But before that, let's dance again. This might be our last chance before we go level up. At this point, you would need to ask Alan Vicky what happened to her son. So the next step is you need to look for Poya. Since we are the main hero, let's go and follow them into the portal. There we go. At this point, we need to help the Eden team repel the Morok's lashes. Since Poya is injured, you need to check on Poya. We need to talk to the Zier if we want to save Ponya. So we need to touch the Book of Ymir again to do some Avengers Endgame type of heist. Wish us luck. then you would need to touch a suddenly appear 3 golden birds. Touch them all. And don't forget to follow the Envoy of Fate Fort. And then, even as a novice, you should defeat Baphomet in front of you. Good luck. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And then you should shout, Moon Prison Power, Mega! And then you get the new quest, which is follow the Envoy Fate forth further. This time, change to Super Saiyan 2. And then you get a brand new task. Follow the Envoy of Fate Fort further. Sounds familiar. Here, you witness the battle of the legendary dragon snakes. So if you haven't finished this story yet, spoilers alert, this time you should defeat the weak recurrent nightmare. No match for you. Next issue should stand in front of Norman. And then you get a literally brand new Super new quest, We'll just follow the envoy of fate forward further. So again, if you haven't finished this story yet, spoilers alert. Point, you should defeat the ultimate Babomet 13. Go ahead, give it your best shot. He did not stand a chance against your best shot. Good job. Check the magic array on the ground. Guess what? The envoy of fate continues to guide you. And we are back to the timeline that we wanted to be in. Good luck. Kill him now! So it looks like fate cannot be changed after all. But wait! Revan and Poya is on the move. Looks like the plot thickens. So it's time for you to shine. You need to join forces with the epic spirit Poya against the weak Morrok. Looks like you did it. You saved Poya. You need to bring back the Infinity Stones back to their own timeline. Okay, so next, we need to move forth with this epic spirit Poya. So where's the circle? I'm stepping on it, but it's not triggering. Should we move to Poya or go back to the circle? Let's try it. Spirit Poya. Now it's time to leave the limited library. Oh no, what's that earthquake? Seems like our job quest isn't finished yet. Onwards to the next quest. We're so close to being a Stella Hunter. Just a few more quests to go. Next, we need to go to Geffen and investigate the meteor. Next, we should need to check the abnormalities nearby. Geffen is devastated. And even if Rayan is the most powerful wizard in Geffen, you would need to set out to help him. Because you're the hero. And there she is, Sarah Ali. Go ahead and attack Sarah Ali. And with powerful magic, I do hope there's a job named Sarah Allen. and that's it. Probably if this is an RPG, the continue screen would show up and you would select yes or no. So ask about what happened because you're in a stage of denial. So next is find Rayan and ask Sarah about Sarah Allen, the girl who kicked your butt. Okay, so a meteor is falling towards Pantera, so we need to check this one out. And then you would need to talk to No One B. Let's click on it. At this point, you should choose on these selections full, tower, and star. And I've selected star. Okay, next quest is to check the situation nearby. So mount the warg and look around. Her warg was affected, so ride the warg ahead and follow the starlight. Thank you. protect the Starring Shard and repel the Menacing Queen Soul. And let's try to touch the Mysterious Beam. So the Starry Shard turned into a Mysterious Maiden. So mysterious. So go ahead, don't be shy. Talk to the Mysterious Maiden. Next task is to listen to Star. Afterwards, use the crystal presented by Estelle. In the underwater temple, look into the magic permit. So there's a lot going on here, just click on away. Up next you will play a game with the Sea Ghost. It's called Switcheroo. Make sure that you follow the Sea Ghost at its highlighted. Go on ahead and collect the Star Shards, you've earned them. Inside the Cavern Dungeon, look for the leads to stars nearby. Do your best and try to defeat the Lonely Nightmare. Try to use the power inside the Stardust Crystal to defeat the Lonely Nightmare. Good job! Time to collect the reward, collect the last shards. Once you're back, you need to explain the current situation to Stella. So we have one last quiz left. Choose wisely. Go on ahead and observe the sea of stars. Go on ahead and walk to the center of the star radiance. So congratulations, you've done it! You're now a stellar hunter, or a fort jump of your choice. So if you've learned something from this video, don't forget to hit the like, comment, and subscribe button, and watch out for more tutorials on my next video. See you next time, this is Razor Eye signing out.